What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Forza Horizon 3. It has been way too long since we played this game. We've had a ton of other games coming out and other stuff going on recently, but not too long ago, we actually got a new car pack for this game. So it's called the Duracell Car Pack. It's got a couple of heavy hitters in there, and we are going to be checking out arguably the most exciting one of the pack, which is the 2017 Chevy Camaro ZL1. So this thing is an absolute monster. It starts at around $60,000, and it's got a 6.2 liter V8 that's putting out 650 horsepower, which is absolutely nuts. 0 to 60 time in about 3.5 seconds, top speed up there around 200 miles an hour. This thing is an absolute monster, especially in that price range. Like, I mean, 60K is a very expensive car, but that's got numbers similar to something like a GTR or even a Lamborghini or Ferrari, you know what I mean? So this thing is an absolute monster. It's a really, really good value for your money, and I can't wait to check this thing out. Camaros have just, they've been around for so long, man. They're a very, very classic car, especially here in America. So let's see what we've got going. Oh, wow, of course, exactly. We've got an American flag one. It's really, really ugly. We aren't going to be going with that. I'm going to take a look at all these custom ones we have here. Nothing that's really speaking to me. Let's see what we have for stock colors. All right, so we've got red, yellow, blue, black, silver, of course. I don't know, man. What do you guys think? Should we go with like a Bumblebee Camaro, or should we stick with the red? The red looks pretty good, I'm not going to lie. Let's go with the red for now. We might keep this thing as a bit of a stock look. I don't know. None of those custom designs really speaked out to me, so we'll see what this looks like for now. We're going to go ahead and upgrade this thing and see where it ends up. I just realized I said speaked out to me. Great English, Trev. Anyway, here we go. So with a little bit of work and 66,000 credits, we are going to take this thing from an 841 S1 class to a 934 S2 class. We're knocking off almost 900 pounds, giving it over 1,000 horsepower. This thing is going to be absolutely insane. Holy cow. So we had spent 60K on the car and then 60K on the upgrade. So this is now $120,000 Chevy Camaro. And now it's time to see what we can do in terms of the look. So let's see what we have here. I know we have some bumper options. We can go with the race bumper, which, I mean, it's going to give us a little bit better performance. I guess we'll go ahead and stick with that. That works for me. We can change our hood up a little bit. Whoa. All these are pretty cool. I kind of like this one. That looks super, super aggressive. All right, so we're going to go with that one. We have the roll cage on there already, so we're going to go ahead and install those for 2,100 credits. For a brand new bumper and hood, that seems like it'd be a really good deal. It's pretty cheap. I've looked into stuff for the GTR, and it's not nearly that price. Let's see what we have here for the rear bumper, see if we have any options. Oh, we have a rear wing option. So we can go with a big wing there or no wing at all. I think we're going to stick with the stock wing, even though this does give us a little bit more performance and increases the handling, pretty much everything except for the speed. I don't think I'm going to do it. It's just, I think that's a little bit too much. All right. So for paint, let's see what we've got going on for paint, because this red and black looks really good. I just think we might add a few accents here, like along the mirrors and stuff like that. Might tint out the windows. So for the color there, that looks good. Do we want to change the hood? Probably not. I think the hood looks good as it is. We're going to go over to special colors here. We'll put some polished carbon fiber on the mirrors. I say we do the same thing for the wing. Just give it a little bit of accent there. The rims don't look bad as they are. What do you guys think? We could go for something a little bit crazy. Some camo rims. I mean, like, something like chrome doesn't even look that bad with this thing. But I think we're gonna... Definitely not wood. I say let's go with the carbon. Just gonna have carbon everywhere, and then we'll black out the windows there. Alright, so like I said, we're keeping it with a pretty simple stock look. But it looks really good. I mean, we have the custom hood, the custom front bumper, but we didn't change too much. Just added a couple accent colors. And overall, this thing's going to look pretty good. It's going to perform even better, though. So hope you guys are excited for that. Let's go ahead and hop inside, see what the interior looks like. Oh, my gosh. Look at that red contrast in the seats. Dude, this thing is beautiful. Okay, so this has the 6-speed manual transition. Dude, apparently I can't speak today. A 6-speed manual transmission is what I was trying to say, but those are actually, they're slower than the automatic. So the 10-speed automatic can get up to around 200 miles an hour. I think the 6-speed manual can only get up to like 173, 175, something like that. So there is a bit of a difference there, but obviously the manual is the way you want to go. That thing sounds pretty mean. That American muscle, baby. Who said muscle cars are dead? I feel like for a while there that we didn't really hear too much about them, but they're starting to make a comeback. And holy cow, is this thing beautiful. Let's hop inside. Look at that hood scoop right there. Takes up so much space, but man, this thing is beautiful. My goodness. So this actually has the exact same engine as the Z06 Corvette. Just kind of transplanted into a Camaro, and this thing is gonna be nutty, dude. I'm so excited. Hope you guys are too. We're gonna go find a race to get into, and we're gonna see how she performs.
Here comes an army of American V8s with some reinforcements from our Australian hosts. It's the Modern Muscle Championship.
All right, sounds good to me. This should be fun. Holy cow. I can't get over this thing. That red, it just, oh, it pops so much. What a beautiful car. I've always been more on the Ford side of things. I have a Ford truck. I like Ford trucks. I like the Mustang a lot, but I've always had respect for the Camaro. You can't doubt the Camaro. A lot of people, like, they choose the Mustang or the Camaro or Ford or Chevy, and they stay directly only loyal to that brand. I've got respect for everybody, and I think the Camaro is a beast of a vehicle, but let's see what she can do. It's been so long since we've raced here in this game, guys. I miss it. I'm so sorry. Like I said, just got kind of caught up with everything else that's been going on. I'm excited to be back, though. I'm ready for a new expansion, like the Blizzard Mountain expansion. Like, it's cool that we got new cars. Honestly, this car pack is pretty disappointing, though. Like, I'm really excited about this. There's an old school GTR that came back. The I think the R33 LM, like track edition. I don't know exactly which one, but apart from that, I mean, there's like a Land Cruiser and some other stuff, but it's just, I don't know, it's been the least exciting car pack so far. So I was kind of sad about that. I'm still waiting on the new Porsche DLC to come out, ever since their exclusivity with EA has ended. So hopefully that comes sometime soon. It's not confirmed yet, but it's just rumored. But yeah, I don't know. Been waiting for new cars. We could get into the multiplayer on this game, though. That's something we haven't really delved too far into yet, and it's something I want to, so we'll see what happens. It's crazy, man. Like, tomorrow, early release for Mass Effect Andromeda. Really excited about that. Definitely gonna be checking that out. We better step our game up here. We're halfway through this race. We're still in sixth place. We've been kind of all over the place. Holy cow, it's hard to see over this thing. Alright, let's see if we can catch these fools here towards the end. Honestly, I do feel a little bit rusty on this game. Like, we haven't played it in so long. It's definitely affecting our play. Woo! Alright. The beauty is it's a 4-race championship, so we've got time to catch up. But we're into a podium position here, so we're gonna be okay. This thing is fast, I'm not gonna lie. Dodge Viper ahead of us. That thing's sexy. And the one thing that I do need to do that, like, we don't even need car packs and other stuff for, I need to get my wheel sim set up, dude. It's sitting in boxes in the living room. As soon as I get that set up, hype over 9,000. Like, think about all the cool stuff we could do. Oh my gosh. I really need to get that set up. That's going to become a priority this week. You guys hold me to it, all right? I want you guys to hold me to it down in the comments. Anyway, we had a third place for our first race back. It's not too bad. I'd prefer better. But we're going to move on to the second race of the championship, and we should pick this up. All right, guys. Race number two. Let's get it. We are going to be battling the elements here. It's a rainy day. Oh, man. This is going to be tough. But I think we're up for the challenge. Big hills, rain, low traction. Lots of expensive muscle cars, usually not a very good mix, but it's going to make for an exciting race here, that's for sure. Alright, let's catch these guys. Dude, this thing, it just... 650 horses, that's so insane. That's seriously nuts. We've got some crazy cars coming out. This thing, the Dodge Demon that's going to be coming out soon, like, they're just... Man, they're churning out these insane cars. Alright. So we're into fourth place after our first lap, which isn't too bad. Let's grab the podium here. Yes. Podium position. Alright. Get around this guy. Oh, come on! Get out of here! Is this a Ford... What is that? A Ford Focus? Just totally stopped in front of us, lost our skill chain, and then blocked us off. Shut the door on us from passing him. I don't even know what this stupid thing is. I don't like it, though. Whew, we are flying right now, boy. Yes. Grab money inside. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on. Muscle your way in there. That's right. All right. We're into first place. First time we've been in first this episode. It's like we shut the rust off a little bit. Shook it off. Woo! That got scary there for a second. We're okay. Ride the wall, baby. Dude, this thing is nasty. Just nasty. So fast. Got a Viper behind us that can't catch up. That corner, we always overshoot a little bit. Woo! I thought the Viper might catch us on the inside right there, but he didn't. Not quite. All right. Solid win there, boys. We had to work for that one, too. That feels good. I like it. First place finish. Okay. Here we come. We needed that win for sure. That was good stuff, guys. Hopefully, we can get another one here. We're in a decent spot in the championship. This is race number 3 of 4, but after that first race performance, honestly, I mean, we aren't very solidified. It could be much better. So that's what we're gonna hope to do with this race here today. Oh my gosh. I do remember this being a pretty challenging course though. This one, it entices you to go fast. Like, it gives you some straights and stuff, and then it throws elevation changes at you. Throws big corners. Like, look at that right there. Like, you want to go fast, but nope. There's a huge jump and then a tree at the end of it. And then we've got the turn at the end of that. So we're going to have to be careful here and make sure we follow our lines. It's not going to be all about that gas pedal. Going to be a little bit more exact with our movements. Doing all right so far. Ah, not our best turn there. Shoot, we're gonna have to catch up to these guys. They're so far ahead. We're on a high difficulty, I can tell. And like I said, we haven't played this in a while, so it's not like I'm right where we left off. I don't know what we left the difficulty on, but holy cow. I'm trying to catch up, but it's not easy. Accelerate through that apex. Oh gosh. We had a good line there and then we ended up off course a little bit, off road. Okay, final lap. This is where we're gonna have to make some moves, Trev. That's not really helping out that much. A lot of wheel spin in this thing. Shoot. Dude, we are so far behind these guys. We're gonna need a big pass on that final turn. And a big section right here. We've got that jump. Gonna have to be careful, but we gotta charge it, bro. I don't think we can catch these guys, honestly. We're gonna see where we end up in the point standings, but I don't think it's gonna be too pretty. These guys are so quick, dude. And this car feels quick, too. That's the thing. I don't know what's going on. I just can't seem to catch him. All right, fourth place finish. for our third race. We're gonna have some work to do in that final race. Let's see the point standings. Wow. He's 6 points ahead of us. So we need to get, we need to place 2 places ahead of Colin, and we also want to be ahead of Marty in the next race. At least 1 ahead of Marty and 2 places ahead of Colin, otherwise we're gonna be in trouble. All right, it's gonna get close. Race number 4, here we go, guys. We have a point-to-point race, and this is pretty crazy, man. I don't know if we're gonna be able to win this championship, honestly. It's not even really up to us at this point. Like, it's a mix of us wanting to do well and us wanting them to do poorly. So I'm gonna race my race. We'll see what happens. If we happen to win it, great. If we don't quite make it, then we can blame it on being a little bit rusty. Cause that first, that first race was just not good. That last race was a really, really tough course that I've always kind of struggled with. So I don't even think it was as much that one, although that one we had the biggest points deficit. Really, it's that first race. We should have raced better. We could have had first there. Look at that. All right, we're off to a good start here. I'm just laying the hammer down the entire time. Not the entire time, but you guys know what I mean. I'm gonna be really aggressive here. I want to make sure we stay ahead of these guys. This type of track kind of plays to our advantage, though, because it's like slaloming through the woods, and usually the AI will slow down a little more than you have to. They play it safe, I play it reckless and go through corners, so we should do pretty well here. Well, we didn't have to slow down that much. Still gotta get right on us. We had to slow down that much on this corner, shoot. I don't see those guys behind us, although sometimes the names change, so. Sometimes from race to race, like different regions and stuff, it'll give you different drivatars you're going up against. It was like Marty and something else were the guys in first place before, so I'm not sure. Huh. All right, bit of a sharp turn here. We'll make sure we make this, nice. And we're coming up on the finish line, so it looks like we are gonna get a first place finish here, but is that gonna be enough? Who knows? He's creeping up on us here, but we got him. Okay, woo! Are we gonna be able to get the gold? We got 20 points. Oh my gosh, we beat him out by 2 points. No way. Holy cow, I think that was probably our closest championship that we've ever had here on this game that we've won. Actually, we may have had a couple of other 2-pointers, but that was insane. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna see you guys in our next episode. We're gonna check out some more cars from this Duracell car pack, and we'll have a good time. So I'll see you guys there. Peace out.